and Interreligious Dialogue Training of Nigerian Students for Sustainable Peace and Development, the University of Uyo Campus Framework, is a postdoctoral fellowship initiative of Dr. Effiong Joseph Udo. Dr. Udo is the Deputy Director, Center for Deep Dialogue and Critical Thinking, and the International Fellow of King Abdullah Abdulaziz International Center for Interreligious and Intercultural Dialogue, KAICIID, based in Vietnam, Republic of Austria, in Europe.
Religious and cultural studies to please come and lead us in the University of Uyo anthem.
The training was held on February 22nd to 24, 2021. It was implemented in collaboration with the Center for Deep Dialogue and Critical Thinking, University of Uyo. It featured intellectual reflections and practical engagement on interreligious dialogue with over 57 participants selected from Muslim Student Society of Nigeria, Joint Christian Campus Fellowship, Nigerian Union of Jewish Students, Students for the Promotion of African Traditional Religious Values, and Nigerian Humanist Student, active on the campuses of the university.
Good afternoon, everyone. The acting deputy director of the Center for Deep Dialogue, Dr. Effiong Udo. The head of Department of Religious and Cultural Studies, Dr. Sylvester Odofia. Staff of the Department of Religious and Cultural Studies who are here. Staff of other departments who are here. English students who are here. Great Nigerian students. I thank God. This is a keynote address presented by the Center for Deep Dialogue and Critical Thinking at an interreligious dialogue training for Nigerian students for sustaining peace and development, the University of Uyo Campus Framework. I welcome you to this special training session of Nigerian students in interreligious dialogue for sustainable peace and development to generate a framework for the University of Uyo campuses to serve as model for other tertiary institutions in the country. Welcome our esteemed participants from various religious strata in our university community. Today's end, dialogue among religions is indispensable, and I dare to describe dialogue as being honest with God, the grounding of groundlessness and the driver of all human aspirations. Without dialogue, religious commitment can become self-destructive and wounding to the human family. In fact, without dialogue, we perish. A particular one. Thank you. God bless you.
Attempts to equip participants with the knowledge, values, and skills an interreligious dialogue that will enable them build bridges of understanding, tolerance, acceptance, and cooperation necessary to guarantee a harmonious, ethno-religious coexistence and cooperation, peace, security, and inclusion in Nigeria. In this direction, the training is related to the achievement of sustainable development goals number four. Goal number four, which has to do with education for the promotion of culture of peace and non-violence. And goal number 16, that has to do with the promotion of peaceful and inclusive societies for sustainable development. This training will feature paper presentations and discussions on dialogue, on religious diversity and pluralism, hate speech, peaceful coexistence, religious freedom, human rights, and critical thinking, as well as a dialogue roundtable on the last day of our training on Wednesday on the topic Management of Interreligious Harmony in Nigeria, the role of religious and state actors. Religion Next is a way to sustain this particular intervention so that it will not be just one time thing. It is so that this kind of thing will go around campuses in Nigeria and beyond Nigeria, as supported by KAICIID, who actually provides the inspiration for this to happen. Religion Next is a platform to mobilize the youth in educational and religious institutions to contribute to efforts that address challenges posed by religious diversity and ideological differences. It seeks to complement the important efforts of religious leaders in platforms such as Nigeria Interreligious Council, NIREC, and Interfaith Dialogue Forum for Peace, IDFP, but whose engagements are sometimes regarded as elitist in nature. As the youth constitute 65% of the total population of Africa, I believe that a significant difference can be made if they are galvanized to be key players in building peace, national integration, and social cohesion. Nigeria, Africa, and the world at large deserve a new, next generation of believers and practitioners of religions who have been transformed by dialogue to be a force for sustainable peace and development of our communities. Religion Next will help to achieve that goal. Religion Next will help in achieving that goal. Therefore, Sipasan Solosa, we are so honored to have you with us. And so, I want to say welcome to you, sir, and thank you very much for coming. Thank you very much.
The training program attracted important dignitaries such as the Vice Chancellor, Professor Effiong Udo, who performed both the opening and closing ceremonies, as well as the induction of trustees, consultants, and members of the new organization, Religion Next.
Of the much talked about center of development, digital team, the great fellow of KAICIID, and the deputy director of the very wonderful center, fellow Nigerians. I don't want to say the way the army should say, you know, when you hear fellow Nigerians, you know that there is one there. That is just to welcome you. I know that I've been done already. I am so pleased to see what is going on here. So I want to use the opportunity to commend the director, the deputy director, and others who are sharing the responsibility of money. That center for a job well done. It is true that in the last outing I was there from the beginning to the end. And that was the one for the Nigerian delegation.
Yes.
To also participate.
Yes.
The memory is still there. And there's no doubt about the fact that this one may erase the other one because this one was quite wonderful. I am happy that you are already putting us up here in the world, the world map. The internet for people to know that there's University of Uyo, and there's also a center. Because from what we have said, we have a website soon also.
Yes, sir.
So it means that anybody could come and then read something there and follow. So it's quite a good way to go. I must commend you for selecting this team. It's a wonderful team, an interreligious dialogue training of Indian students. Not for ordinary peace, but for what?
Sustainable peace
and development. My other responsibility was to declare this wonderful event open. This is 9 o'clock, check your time. Are you following? So it is my pleasure to declare this training, today's training, open. For the glory of our Creator, and the benefit of humanity. Thank you.
I am in the Department of Philosophy, Faculty of Arts, University of Uyo, and my religion is Islam. I am in 300 level, and my state of origin is Edo State. The food I love most is a soup called in Edo language, Osamora, that is Ora soup,
Samora,
and Padenyan.
I'm from Associates, Department of Informatics and Surveying, Environmental, I'm 300 level. The food I like best is fried rice.
My name is Samuel Sekavishet, Faculty of Law, Lakwa my origin, and my best food is afang and strong fufu. And I'm also a Christian, I'm the president of the John Christian Campus Fellowship.
Thank you. My name is Queen Effiong Udo, a 500 level student of the Department of Agricultural Economics and Extension, Faculty of Agriculture. I'm a Christian. My best food is afiafi.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. I'm the vice president of the Joint Christian Campus Fellowship.
Thank you.
Religion as an attack, and you use it as a weapon, and you see every other person as an enemy, and you want to react to that situation. So what you're going to do is not going to be objective at all. And anybody and everybody has a tendency to this. If you fail to take what we are trying to project here into consideration, everybody has a tendency to this. If you're a Christian, you have a tendency to it. If you're Muslim, you have a tendency to it. And all it takes is remember that there is some truth, there is some meaning, and there is something good in every other group or every other religion. So that yours is not meant to be like a weapon, or it's not meant to. Your own doctrine or whatever you look for or whatever you feel is right in what you believe in is not meant to be like a weapon against another person. So that's why I was talking about how it sounds in ethic when you are like attacking somebody. And you know, in Nigeria today, we need to preach this to ourselves. What I mean by we, I mean departing from what Dr. Odo said. When I say we now, I'm referring to all of us here seen individually. So if I do it for myself, you do it for yourself. And we just know that there is something good in every other person, and that what I have is not the ultimate. If I give some allowance, then my religion is not going to be a weapon of attack by myself or another person. So generally, it is a call to objective dialogue and appreciation of the other, as against when you see everything must be an attack. Every religion, every article of faith, everything you believe in must be against another person's belief, and that is what we don't want.
Beautiful. Thank you very much.
Others were the registrar of the university, Mr. Anyedia Basi Udofia, the chairman of the Committee of Deans, Professor Idara Akpabio, Nabi Malaki Umar Fateman, the Chief Rabbi of Akwaibom State and Grand Rabbi of Jewish Community in Nigeria, Sheikh Dr. Okosani El Olalekan, Vice Chairman Supreme Council for Islamic Affairs, Ubong Dr. Clement Oton of Itu Traditional Rulers Council, and Reverend Dr. Ndwesu Ekwere, Chairman Christian Association of Nigeria, Akwaibom State, as well as the co-facilitator Dr. Donatus Upo, Dr. Hassan Bello, Dr. Itefia Ikanem, Dr. M.M. Umoren, and Dr. Mrs. Kudirat Bimbo Sani.
Friends, it is about time that we take a first and a very important lecture. I have to state up front that this is a lecture that is not going to be all lecture. It's going to be spiced up with some activities, group activities as well. So, once it is the time for group activity, just note your group number. And then as you assemble together, then you can choose a leader among you for the purpose of reporting the outcome of your discussion in that group. So, without further ado, we would like to take the first lecture on interreligious dialogue to explore the very concept of dialogue, and to look at a brief history of dialogue, and then to look at the ethical dimensions, and of course the practical dimensions of dialogue. And I think it is important that we do this, because you would be better equipped to know what dialogue is all about. Dialogue as opposed to the ordinary street understanding of what dialogue is all about. And I'm pleased to take this paper along with you.
Some of the topics treated at the 3 days training event included: what is dialogue? Exploring its conceptual, historical, and ethnic landscapes, religious diversity, and tensions in Nigerian school campuses, the exigencies of interreligious dialogue education, the Quran, religious diversity, and harmonious coexistence in Nigeria, the Bible, religious pluralism and peaceful coexistence in Nigeria, human rights and state of religious freedom in Nigeria, critical thinking, dialogue and the future of religion in Nigeria, among others.
Critical thinking and dialogue for future of religions in Nigeria. Majority, great numbers of human beings are what? Religious. So religion is very important for human beings. And now, after modern period in history of Western thought, with the advance of science and technology, it was considered that religion would be something of the past. That science, technology would destroy religion. Human beings would no more have needs of religion. But unfortunately, religion still persists in the world. And now when we talk of the postmodernist world, we are going back to where? To religion. Now, the search for God, who is his religion, must always openly or secretly be present in human societies. We are therefore to examine what will happen to religion. Will religion disappear in the world? If religion is not going to disappear in the world, what type of religion do we want? How do we want religious people to live? Therefore, critical thinking and dialogue, it is important for us to understand the future of religion. Not only in Nigerian society, but also in a global society.
And every other person, human being, around you is a human being. And if you think, person, you were created by God. God also created you. You have a date with God. He will also have a date with God. If you can relate with ourselves as to God, the Creator, the Supreme Being, made us all, and to Him all that we return. That way, we will not only achieve religious freedom in our country, in doing that, we will also achieve fundamental human rights.
Wa nusalli ala rasulina al-karim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May peace and blessing of God be upon all of us. As you have heard, what I want to discuss with you is the Holy Quran, religious diversity, and harmonious coexistence in Nigeria. Alhamdulillah, all praise belong to Almighty Allah. Shortly before, we have seen a film or video they have released to you now. It's about a Muslim taking care of the church in Pakistan. And this is the true picture of Islam. And what this man did is not doing it politically. Not politically. That is the true teaching. What he has learned from the Prophet of Islam, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. How? We have it in record that Medina, that became forbidden for the Christians today to visit, was left open yesterday for the Christian to offer their service inside the same mosque. It's a record. It's in the record. What has happened? Group of the Christians from Nigerian is not very far away from Medina. They paid the Prophet a visit to dialogue with him on religious matters. And they continue. Suddenly, the Holy Prophet discovered that the Christians are about to take a leave. He now asked them why. He said, because the time of their service is approaching and they would like to leave for that service. The Holy Prophet now asked them, is it not worshiping of God? They said, yes. He said, why can't you do it here? Where we are here is also the house of God. Where we are here is also a house of God. okay? If we are permitted, then you are permitted. They offered their service inside his mosque during the lifetime of the Prophet of Islam himself. Now, what is the problem? And go back to history. The first person, when the Holy Prophet himself received the revelation, the first person he visited for clarification is a Christian, Waraka bin Naufal. So it means for you to really understand the content of the Quran, you need a very strong background of Arabic language.
The training also featured an outdoor event, an interreligious football match, group workshops, and educative video shows.
Anything we have achieved with this outcome, and what is it? Can somebody mention one or two things that we have achieved? Oh, flexibility. It makes you flexible. With regards to our training,
Exercise.
Somebody has mentioned very important point here.
Yes.
What?
Relationship.
As well as a dialogue roundtable on the topic management of interreligious harmony in Nigeria. The role of religious and state actors.
That is like setting the stage for the dialogue to begin. Let me first of all recognize the presence of the registrar of the University of Uyo, Mr. Anyedi Abasi Odofia. Please put your hands together. Thank you very much. And let us also be aware that the media people are here and that what we are doing here is going to be in the national news. However, the director of our center has given that brief introduction and, charting a direction for the dialogue to continue. My job here is to set the ground rules, few ground rules, to guide the dialogue. For in the practice of dialogue, these principles must be made known. Principle of equality, as we bring the various leaders of our religion here, for the sake of this dialogue, there is no religion, no religious leader here that is superior to another. So we are all equal.
The capping of events was the inauguration of the Religious Next Foundation for Youth and Peace Building, a platform for youth and their mentors in educational and religious institutions to take active part in building a peaceful, united and secured Nigeria, African continent and the world at large.
What him called Abraham from his father's house to leave the deities and doctrines of their fathers and go to a land they will send him. That was when the ball was set for Judaism.
Now let us look at this. When God created Adam and Eve in the Garden of Eden, he told them, the first thing God told Adam after creating them, he said, go and multiply. Go and multiply. Fill the earth. Subdue it. He was giving a law. He gave a law to a human being, to a person that he created. That means he sets emotion on. That there is a relationship between the creator and the creator, between the divine and that which is considered mortal. So when God gave Adam the law to be multiplied, to fill the earth, to dominate the earth, and at a point he even told him that this tree in the fruit, in the middle of the garden, you should not eat. For the day you taste of it, you will surely die. So he was talking, there was a relationship, there was a God-man relationship there. So God was making a law. You can see even when Cain, that which is referred to as Cain in the Christian literature, is Cain in Judaic or Judaism literature. When he told Cain, you kill your brother and you are tightening your fingers because you know that you have committed evil. That means there was a law. The law did not start from Abraham. The law did not start from Moses. The law started when God created man in his own image in the Garden of Eden.
This 3 days event have certainly equipped participants with the knowledge, values and skills in interreligious dialogue to enable them build bridges of understanding, tolerance, acceptance and cooperation necessary to guarantee a harmonious ethno-religious coexistence and achievement of sustainable peace, security and inclusion in Nigeria.
Agricultural Economics and Extension, the Faculty of Agriculture, University of Uyo. By religion, I'm a Christian. This is the second day of this wonderful program. I really enjoy the program because it has widened my horizon about my perspective towards different religions. For example, I grew up in the north and I have seen one or two things about them, some things I like, some I don't like, and I've related with some other persons and they've not been able to really tell me why they behave the way they do based on their Quran, like from their holy book, like I have learned today, for example, in the course of this the lecture delivered by Dr. Bello. It was really inspiring. I now understood why some of them behave the way they do and the disparity among them. This has helped me a long way. I will now work with them in love. I'll tolerate them and build this understanding between me and them because of what I have gained, the knowledge I have gained in the course of this training. Not only just for the Muslim folks, for other religions. In fact, it got me thinking in the hall. I was thinking like, how would my fellow Christians, for example, see me? Because I'm a leader, I'm an influencer, and I begin to talk in a certain way. They may begin to feel, is she okay? But I've gathered enough facts and evidence to prove to them that we are one, we serve the same God, and that we can achieve more if we work together as a team. If we work together as a team, we'll achieve this Nigeria that we want to. That's the goal we want to see. We'll be able to actualize them, and the Nigeria we want to see, we'll be able to build this Nigeria together in unity, despite the differences in our religions.
So, from yesterday to today, I've improved my social skills and I've also learned that religious harmony isn't just the way it seems, how we learn about it. It goes beyond saying, oh, this one is just a Muslim. It's just about how to coexist, how to learn to coexist together to develop a common goal, to achieve peace, mutual understanding and social development.
I seem very, very alien to you and everyone, but Judaism as a religion that has come to stay. It is one of the world international religions. When you see the Muslims, you see Christians, you see Judaism. In the world, those are the three international religions that are recognized by every country that are in the UN Charter. So this dialogue, I'm very, very elated to be part and parcel of the program organized by the Center for Deep Dialogue and Critical Thinking.
thinking.
Really exposed to us to see from the light of, because in sociology, I studied sociology and the University of Uyo, we have this theory that when you are understanding people, you should understand them from the point of view of the participants. Mm. So with this training, I've been able to understand diverse religions.
I feel very delighted. I feel very happy because I see a better future for the younger generation. And as far as religion is concerned, I mean, as a priest, I have to be very concerned about what happens in our religion. And what is happening in this world now, the training tells me that there is a future for the younger people as far as religion is concerned. And not just a future, there is a better future, a more peaceful future, a more tolerant future. And that can only bring joy and delight. For the trainees, my advice would be don't stop at the education. Go into advocacy. Let it not end today. We want to see this carried out in action. When you get the knowledge, let other people know. Let other people come to realize that what are we fighting for?
What is this?
We can do it together. And if we do it together, then the next generation is going to be a better generation. So my main advice is, apart from getting the knowledge, put it into practice and let other people know that we need to come together for the benefit of the youth of this nation.
We extend our appreciation to International Fellows Program KAICIID, Vietnam, Austria, for substantially supporting the training and the Center for Deep Dialogue and Critical Thinking for the collaboration to implement the training. We especially thank the Vice Chancellor of the University of Uyo, Professor Effiong Udo for hosting the training, the Chairman of the Inauguration of Religious Next, Reverend Ekpedeme M. Efanga, the Vice Chairman, Elder Mrs. Edo Emma E. J. Udo, as well as the distinguished trustees, consultant, and indeed all participants at the training.